Hello class. Good morning students. Now we will start our class. Today topic is MySQL chapter 7. Let's start with RDBMS or RDBMS terminology. MySQL database. But a database system is basically a computer based record keeping system. Okay. Before we proceed to explain the MySQL, first we have to understand few terms which are regularly used in MySQL. Like first is database. So you know ki what is a database? Collection of tables with related data items. Table is a relation in a database. It can store logically related data item. Data must be atomic in a cell. Now when we talk about column, or we can say attribute. A one column contain data of one or same data type. For example, the column roll number. So roll number is a name of attribute, and the data type is, it may be integer, or we can create roll number. If you want, then we can create the data type of varchar. But basically roll number we always choose integer data type. So column is known as attribute. Now row, we can say row, tuple. A row of a relation is generally referred as a tuple. We can say also records. So we can understand, for complete information of one student, indicate one record or one tuple. Degree. Degree means total number of attribute in a relation is known as degree. Cardinality. This refer to the number of tuple in a relation. Remember it, in a board exam number of time ask this question, ki what is degree and what is cardinality? Yeah, how many degree and how many cardinality in a one table. Then primary key. A primary key is a unique key. A key value cannot occur twice in a table. Now see this figure. In this figure, I am creating a one table. The name is clients. And the attribute in this tables are client ID, client first name, client last name, client city, other fields. So these are attribute. When we talk about records or tuples, there are number of 6 records in this table. So total cardinality equals to 6 and degree is equals to 5. So what means of degree and what means of cardinality? Number of attribute in a relation is known as degree, and number of tuples in a relation is known as cardinality. Now, how we can access database in MySQL? We can access database in MySQL with the help of use command. So we can write the command use, and then we can define the name of the database. Like in this example, I am using, the database name is school. So school is a database and the command name is use. With the help of show databases, we can display all the databases list within the MySQL which are available. And with the command of show tables, we can show all the table in the database. Now the next is classification of SQL statement. We know very well the structured query language is the set of commands that is recognized by all the RDBMS. And that help us to create and operate on the relational databases. So these commands are DDL commands. It is data definition language command. When we talk about DML, it means data manipulation language command. DCL, data control language command. TCL is a transmission control language commands. Now, when we talk about DDL, now if you can check these commands, define in DDL. The examples of DDL commands are like create, alter, drop, truncate. Same in DML, we can use the select, insert, update, delete. These are DML command. And grant, revoke comes in the category of DCL. And same like commit, rollback, save point commands come in the category of TCL. Now, what is DDL? Basically, whenever we talk about DDL, it means data definition language command. It means we are talking about the schema or the description of the database. Or we can say the schema means how the database is created. Like the command is create. How many objects in this table? How many attributes in this table? So create commands in the category of DDL. Same like alter. Alter is also a DDL command. Whenever we talk about alter command, it means we are changing the structure of the existing database. It means once again, we are working on the structure. Like drop, it means we want to remove some object from the database. It means I can remove one column. So once again, we are working on the structure. Now, when we talk about the DML command, DML means the commands that allow you to perform the data manipulation, retrieval, insertion, deletion, modification of data stored in a database. So it means we are working on data values. We can manipulate, we can change the data values with the help of DML commands. Like first is select command. How we can use this command? We can use this command select and then we can write the column name from table name. Retrieve data from a database, we can use the command select command. Like insert command, it means we want to insert the data values within the existing table. So we have to use the command insert command. So comes in this category DML. Same like update. Update means changes or modification within the existing data which is available in a table. Like I want to change the value which are already stored in a one column, for an example marks. In one column marks is 45 and I want to change the marks from 45 to 55. So I can use this command update command because I want to change in a data values. Delete, it means delete is also a DML command. Remember it, drop command always comes in the category of DDL because with the help of drop command we can change the structure, schema of the table. But with the help of DML command, we can delete the record which are present in a database table. The next command is DCL command. DCL is a short name of Data Control Language command. Basically, which provides some permissions or right of the database system. There are only two commands comes in this category, that is grant and revoke. Grant command help us to allow the user access privilege to the database. And the revoke command, just we can again privilege given by the using grant command, we can take back from the users, or we can say withdraw the user access privilege. The next command is Transmission Control Language command, TCL command. Always deal with a transaction within a database. There are only four commands which come in this category: commit, rollback, save point, set transactions. Commit always used after completion of a transactions. Rollback, it means rollback a transaction in case of any error occur or we want to perform some other action. Then we can use the rollback to move back to the previous stage. Save point help us to create a point, so we can say just like a bookmark, so we can define with the rollback to go back to that previous save points. Save points is just like a marking. And the set transaction specify the characteristics of the transactions command. So these are the MySQL commands which are classified in SQL. And with the help of these commands, we can perform different type of work. For example, suppose we want to create a tables, then we have to use the command create command. With the help of create table command, we can create one table. But before creating a table, you must have to use the database. Then within a database, you can create a table. So we can create a table with the help of create table, table name. Then after we can define the attribute name. For example, I am creating a table of student. So my command is create table student. Then we can use the parenthesis. Then give the attribute like roll number. Roll number and the data type integer. Then after I am using the next attribute, first put the comma. Then we can define the student name, S name. So student name is a, we can take a varchar data type. Within a bracket, we can define the size, let's say 20, then put the comma, then after I am using age, then the age in integer. So we can take integer, comma, let's say date of birth, DOB, then data type should be date type. And then close the parenthesis and then put the semicolon. You can get a message table is created.